Okay, so today we are going to understand a very important research that is regarding the use of portable, purchasable air filters. You know, a lot of people are buying purchasable, portable air filters. First of all, I would want to quote the WHO. The WHO says that use of portable air filters, you know, those things that you can buy with HEPA filters and put it in your room, was not advised for airborne infection control because it, you know, the most prominent way is by using air changes per hour, having outdoor air come inside. But the air filters have no such provision usually. Most air filters do not have the provision of having an external duct coming inside with the outdoor air, which can cause the air changes per hour. So the most prominent way is dilution ventilation. So in this research that we are looking at, it is by PLOS One. It is published in PLOS One by Ashley Hammond, Tanzina Khalid, Hannah Thornton, Claire A. Woodwall, Alastair D. Hay. Now, most important, this is under the Creative Commons license. The copyright is 2021, Hammond et al. Under Creative Commons Attribution License, which permits unrestricted use as long as I'm citing the author. And the Creative Commons license is right here. It is visible over here. It is attribution 4.0. And this is the disclaimer of warranties. Please read it very carefully. Now, what did this study do? So, what this study did is that it basically took in a lot of research already done. And out of that research already done, it found out whether these purchasable portable air filters were actually filtering viruses. So these, you know, researchers identified by database search. So they typed in certain keywords into the database of prominent, you know, repositories of research. So these include MESH terms, and they were searched in Medline, Embassy, and Cochrane for articles published in any language between January 2000 and March 2021 was the time when they searched. So no article has been taken which is prior to 2000 year 2000 January. So what they did is that they basically took in, you know, a lot of these criteria which were excluded and included. So one of the criteria that was included was that no paper before 2000, because they wanted to make sure it is the latest research. And apart from that, they had this simple criteria. Which was, you know, about the inclusion and exclusion of certain things. So they only took inclusion criteria. So they took any population age group. They didn't take outdoor settings. They didn't take aircrafts. They took all the countries. They took households, care homes, schools, nurseries, universities, workplaces, public buildings, primary care practices, and hospitals. They took all the portable commercially available filters, including the ones which had HEPA filter. So, you know, as a control, as a comparer, they used, you know, there was no other filter used in the spaces. So that was in the studies that they, you know, read and then they analyzed. All the papers were published after 2000, randomized control trials, non-randomized control trial interventions, cohort-based case control, all types of studies were analyzed by them. They did not analyze any qualitative study. All studies were quantitative. And then, you know, they made sure that they were systematic reviews, systematic reviews like this one was not included in the study. So it was only studies, actual experiments that were studied by them, and no review article was reviewed by them again. So then so this is how they did. Papers identified by database. They started with 16,847 papers, out of which 1,097 duplicates were removed. So that leaves them with 15,750 papers, which were then excluded, you know, based on the title. You know, a lot of them were excluded because even though the search keywords gave them papers, but they were excluded based on the title because they did not meet the standard. So what they found out was that out of these 99 abstracts were reviewed, out of that 81 were excluded because some were non-portable, 29 of them. Some were study conducted prior to 2000, then there was no use of filters in 12 of them. Experimental filters were used, review papers, seven of them were review papers, some of them, three of them were aircraft study, and you know, there was others were only with face respirators. So then they, out of these 18 papers, again excluded 16 because non-portability reasons, aircraft study or experimental studies conducted in germ-free chambers. So they only found out, it is unfortunate, and this reveals a gap in the study, in the current situation, because there are so many commercially available filters present, you know, which you can buy and put in your house, but they lack. So this is the list of the commercial portable air filters present: Philips, Dyson, Airvia, Homedia, Aerobiotics, Bühler, Winix, Dimplex. All of them claim that they remove 99.97 percentage of ultrafine particles. Some of them talk about virus removal, but there has been no study till now which has proven, which is peer reviewed, that it actually removes the virus. So that does not mean that these filters are not doing a good job. It just means that there is a lack of research in this area, that these portable filters can actually filter out the viruses. Even though there have been two studies which these people found out of the 16,000, which worked with bacteria. But we have to understand that bacteria as such is much bigger than the virus. So the point is not that it may not filter a virus. The point here is very clear that there might be a situation where this particular filter, you know, is not tested to do anything against the virus. So the best way currently available is to use dilution ventilation. Dilution ventilation is the cheapest, easiest way in which you are simply, you know, using outdoor air which can be filtered against, you know, major particles, and that flushes away the inside concentration of viruses. So this was under the Creative Commons license attribution 4.0. All the credit goes to the creators of this research. So please, you know, understand that there is no current study on the efficacy of portable air filters against viruses. So I hope you all remain safe, and you please read this paper fully. The link is available in the description. Thank you very much.